मंगलम श्रियस्तांतरे कल्याण निधरे निधरेर्धिनाम श्री वेंकट निवासाय श्रीनिवासाय मंगलम भूत्वा दुहुयदाध्यमन्वहम् श्रियः पञ्चदशर्कञ्च श्रीकामस्य पतञ्जपेत् कर्दमश्चैव चिक्लीत इति विश्रुताः
ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ कर्नाटक सन्मान्य यड्यूरप्पारवरे ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश गौरवान्वियुलु जगन मोहन रेड्डी गारु ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर एंडोमेंट्स गवर्नमेंट ऑफ कर्नाटक सन्मान्य कोटा श्रीनिवास पूजारी रवरे रिस्पेक्टेड चेयरमैन टीटीडी गौरवान्वियुलु सुब्बा रेड्डी गारु एंड अदर डिग्निटरीज ऑन द स्टेज The people of Karnataka, earlier Mysore state, have had centuries of bond with the Lord of the Seven Hills. The Maharajas of Mysore, with the blessings of the Lord, have had the unique privilege to serve the Lord and be patrons of the temple and its devotees by way of bearing expenses for annual festivities, making facilities for devotees, doing dana of funds and jewelry, and support in the temple administration. They had also established Kalyan Mandapa, cottages and infrastructure at Tirumala for the benefit and convenience of the devotees. The same has devolved upon the government of Karnataka under its endowment department. It was in 1964 that the foundation stone for a new Mysore Chowdhury that was laid by the then Prime Minister of India, Sri Lal Bahadur Shastri. It is only in the fitness of things now that the present foundation stone be laid by the honorable chief ministers of both the states, symbolizing the existing brotherhood between its people. Presenting here is a brief overview of the project. This is the existing Karnataka Bhavan Chowdhury, the KPS block, the existing Mandapam, the Pushkarini, and the temple. We have about 6.67 acres of land facing the West Mada Street, right opposite the Sanctum Sanctorum. In Tiruvai, a local Purana, it is mentioned that the Lord of the Seven Hills was known for his love of flowers and flowery decorations which he is adorned with throughout the year, giving him the sorbiquet Alankara Priya, We have drawn inspiration from this concept and have named and themed the new chowl trees on the same. We have Kanakambaram, which is the existing KPS, a total number of 84 rooms. Sampige, Sampangi in Telugu, Sevantige, Chamanti, Mallige, Tavare, Pushkarini renewal and the Mandapam. So a total of 4 new structures and existing structure remodeling is being taken up under this project. A total square foot of over 3 lakh square foot is being constructed. This is an overview of all the blocks and the Pushkarini put together. In each of the blocks, we have tried to use the local tradition and the flower theme. Like in Sampige, we have used the color theme as a mood board and metal wall art depicting colors of the Sampige flower. In Sevantige, we have metal art and Gandifa art, which is local to Karnataka. In Tavare, which is the sweet block, we have about 36 rooms. We someday hope to host the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh once this is done, because this is modeled on the Padmavati and Sri Krishna, and it has lotus motifs throughout. Mallige is the name we've given to the Kalyana Mantap. It has a seating capacity of over 400, and the Mallige motif is in the walls and in the flooring and the ceiling. Kanakambaram is the existing block which we are updoing. This was the same block which was the foundation stone for which was laid by the then Honorable Prime Minister. It will have art from Kalamkari and leather puppetry as wall art. This is the existing Kalyana Mantapam where the Lord visits twice in Pallavotsavam. The existing Kalyani will be remodeled on this pattern. On behalf of the state of Karnataka, we would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, and the TTD Chairman, Subba Reddy Garu, for having consented to take up this project through the TTD. Thank you very much, sir. We would also like to thank the Executive Officer, Sri Anil Kumar Singhal Garu, who has helped us in resolving the long pending court case, without which this day would not have been possible. Special thanks are also due to the Additional Executive Officer Dharma Reddy Garu and the Chief Engineer Ramesh Reddy Garu for their constant positive support through the last 6 months, without which today would really not have been possible. This entire project is being developed and to be executed by the TTD through its engineering division. Hope that in the coming days, in this 3 lakh square foot, we hope to house around 1800 pilgrims in a single day. This would meet the demand from thousands of devotees across Karnataka. We now request the Honorable Chief Ministers to kindly unveil the plaque for the foundation stone.